Hi, I'm Laura. Laura, I'm still French. I think this is the last time that I'm gonna say that at the introduction of one video. I'm gonna watch The 100 Season 6 Episode 3. I have to warn you that next week I'm gonna move in on a new apartment, and this new apartment is at 400 kilometers from this one, so I think I'm gonna be late for The 100 Season 6 Episode 4. Sorry for that, but I'm gonna be late maybe for 1 or 2 days. About the episode 2, I really enjoyed the episode 2 after the episode 1 was really hard for me, because you know, after fucking season 5 I was really like depressed. This show is really a show where I'm really excited usually, and after season 5 I was really like depressed. I was really stressed about this new season. The first episodes of this new season are gonna be really crucial for me to be excited again about this show. The episode 1 really didn't succeed at all to bring me back to excitement. The episode 2 was really great and I was again excited. So right now I'm like, it has to continue like that, to continue to be great, to be well written. The new storyline about this new world, about the red sun, about them changing with the sun, about the flashbacks also, about the how this new world was grown. So now, yes, it's really like I'm still in love with this show, but it's like in a relationship. I'm not as in love with this show as I was at the first seasons. At the first seasons, I was enjoying this show so much, and the season 5 was like that, really, was, you know, it's like in the old Facebook, our relationship, me and this show, was, it's complicated, you know what I mean? So now, I want to find the excitement again with this show. I'm this close to be like that, to be again involved in this show. So yes, keep it that way, please. About the characters, Clark needs to find a new place in this group again, and they have to accept it. Bellamy has to ask forgiveness for what he just did to Clark on the last episode. It was not a good Bellamy moment for me, it was really rough. Raven, you know, I'm don't like what the writers are doing with Raven on the two first episodes, because she lost everything on the last season, every man that she loved, and it's happening again, and they are trying to make us dislike her, and no, I'm not gonna dislike this character. I love her so much, so that's it. Octavia needs to chill a little. She's not a monster for me, and the scene on the last episode was really here to show us that she's not a monster and she wants to die. Since years now, really, since seasons, do you remember that moment on the cave with Ilian? She wants to die because she feels like she died in the inside, she's dead inside. So really, she wants to die, she doesn't care about her life because she doesn't think that she has a life anymore. So she needs to chill for beginning, and after that to figure it out how her life can be, how can she just live, and it's gonna be really hard for her. That's it. I'm gonna watch the episode 3 right now, and again I warn you, I'm gonna be late for the episode 4, I'm sorry for that, but I'm moving on a new apartment next week and I'm really happy about that. If you are watching my reaction videos about Peaky Blinders, you already knew that, because I kept the the sequence when I received the call that told me that I had my apartment, and I was like like that really. So yes, I'm happy to move in on a new apartment, so I'm gonna be late for episode 4, but it's for a good thing. So let's go for this new episode.
He's not
what? Hello! You, new leader of this weird world. I hope you're a good guy. That's
he's
a...
already dead.
What? No. No, 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 no.
Fortunately, for your death is not the end.
Oh my god.
What?
Trust me, I know.
That's disgusting.
Poison made the demon Gabriel believe he could walk on water.
The demon Gabriel? I thought Gabriel was the doctor on the last episode on the flashbacks.
Lock them up.
That's logical. They just discovered that they killed some of them, so that's normal.
What are you even doing here?
I can't.
Oh, come on!
They call it Joe Juice after Josephine Prime. That would be her name.
Probably. Josephine Prime, okay. The girl from the flashbacks.
Sanctum was colonized by a team from Earth made up of 4 families. The Primes. Their blood rules us still.
Make way for the Primes.
There are worse things in this world than eclipse-induced psychosis. And the worst of them would love to get their hands on the weapons Kaylee says on your ship.
Worst things? Or worst?
Which is why you'll be on the team search retreat.
But my child is out there, so I'm going to get her.
Please. We have things to discuss. Are you the leader of your people or not?
She is.
Oh! Oh, that's so nice, that's so sweet. Thank you, Benjamin.
We'll bring Maddie back. I promise.
Oh! Like you promised to not to protect her and to not let her be that?
In my dreams, I see a commander who frightens me.
Shaitan. The Dark Commander.
What about that Dark Commander? Why don't we hear about him before that?
That's why we must keep training.
Now the grounders of this new world. Clark, I love you so much. Oh. I know this is just a bait, but I can't help myself. To live peace, to live like that, to be happy with Maddie, with all of them like that.
You can stay.
I decided.
So when they are leaving the dorm,
Clark, I have to get out of here. Okay.
You feel it? Oh, this is gonna be a trauma for him.
What do you
say? Shrunk on the hell.
Oh, my baby, no!
I left her on the ship because I thought the
she would be safer wherever Octavia wasn't.
Stop with that, with Octavia, please. Give her a chance to change. Help her to change. It's weird to see Jordan flirting with someone, but it's also sweet. We want him to be happy. He lost his wonderful parents.
Yes.
Sorry for interrupting. I mean, I was actually reading some stories about her.
No!
The man killed the villa by fire.
Oh, there are the children of Gabriel.
Children of Gabriel, gather round!
I said it first.
God, what were you doing
now? Oh, Clark!
What?
I can cry, I'm so happy for her. And of course, Bellamy is not here to see that.
Beautiful.
Yes, but I want Bellamy to be here to see that.
I know why.
Yes. That's about the end of the world. In that case, maybe I'll tell him to fire the first shot.
That was big enough for both of us.
Oh, oy, oy, oy.
Oh my god. I'm surprised I got him.
It's really nice to see her.
Simple pleasures here.
Yes, having just simple pleasures.
How many people have you killed, Clark?
Ooh, don't ask.
Or should we call you one head up?
Jordan!
My friend Jordan likes to talk. I did what I had to do to save my people. Would you do it again? I will not apologize.
Yes.
For saving the people that I love.
She will do it again.
We can change.
I believe you want to, Clark.
Yes.
I do. I just don't believe you can.
Come on, she can.
Please understand, violence is a contagion.
And no,
sorry.
In another, she doesn't have to change because she's good and she can just live happy. I know it from my heart.
When your friends return, I suggest you fly back to your mothership. Not yet.
Come on.
What?
What are you gonna do? Leave me here?
Yes.
Your own good.
No.
Monty gave us.
Come on. Okay. He's mad at her. He's angry with her. But the main goal of his character was to protect her from others all of his life. And this change on his character is not a good change, a worldwide change. I'm sorry, but I can't. No!
You should have died in that gorge anyway.
Octavia!
My sister died a long time ago.
Stop that! Really? I can't. I'm not seeing that happening with the Bellamy Blake that I love. From season 1 to season 4.
Tomorrow, everything changes. I've been waiting for naming day all my life.
What is naming day?
Now, I need a boy who makes me wish I had more.
What was that?
That was my first guess.
Don't let anyone else.
She's gonna die, and she knows that she's gonna die. She's gonna be sacrificed or something like that. That's nice. What? That's not nice. Oh, Clark, you're gonna do it again. So you knew her. So there is a spy baby.
We have the same blood, Clark.
Okay.
Brother went out to Delilah.
Where's Russell? The chosen
okay.
Of
the master
even took my rose.
Princess Clark. Perfect. Not living up makes her a target.
It does. Which is why we can't tell them about Maddie.
Oh là là. Oh. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Can someone explain what is happening right now?
If you want to be so sure.
If you should mind.
Cool. But can you explain what all is this about?
Charmaine deals it?
Yes.
Escort this woman past the shield right now. Just wait.
What?
Your face is in our history books next to Hitler and Bin Laden.
Please.
Oh, really?
What about the baby?
What?
She's got before the children of Gabriel do, because if she joins forces with them, we're gonna need more than a radiation shield to protect us.
The others are dead.
And you're about to be.
That was well done.
A child of royal blood and a girl from Earth. Not bad for a day's work.
Mm.
Let's see the old man reject us now.
Oh, this episode was really great, but too much information on it. Really, too much. I don't know where to start. The children of Gabriel. Gabriel was the doctor on the flashbacks. Josephine loved him. But the descendants of Josephine are on the village. And the descendants of Gabriel are outside the village, so they broke up at some point. There's something there. They are trained to move in the village, to come inside with hostages, because they want to be protected by the dome, okay? What about that naming day? I'm not sure it's really a good thing, that naming day, because Delilah was saying that the kiss with Jordan may be the last kiss for her. She was talking about not having enough time, so was she saying that because of the children of Gabriel capturing her? For another reason, I'm not sure that this naming day it's really a good thing after all. There is something also with the blood. The night blood means that you are royal. Okay, why not? But how can they have the night blood? They have the night blood because of Josephine, so maybe she found out how to have the night blood, but for what? For doing what? And the grounders, the new grounders, the children of Gabriel, are there more of them? I can't imagine that there are only one little group. I think there are more of them. And that thing about Yoda, they learned in the history books that Yoda is like Hitler. What did she do to be on that prisoner ship at the first time that can let them think that she is like Hitler? Really? This is gonna be a really few. On the next episode, that thing about Yoda. Because yes, if she will join the children of Gabriel, that's not gonna be good for the village. Really, a lot of questions and a lot of information during this episode, but this is great. This is really great because this is one of the things that The Andred is good at to make us think about all the possibility, all of that, to make a story, a big story with a lot of storylines. So yes, it's really great to go back on that field with The Andred, I mean for the writers, to give us good storylines, good stories for a whole season, like during season one when they were discovering the new earth, the ground earth, all of that, with Mount Weather during season two, with Pramfaya, with all of that. It was great to have those storylines, and this big story for a whole season that was missing during season 5 also, and that was the reason also for being a little disappointment, no, a big disappointment for season 5. About the characters, Clark, to see Clark trying to convince them that she can change, they can just live happy with them. It was really great to see her like that, because in her heart she really wants that, she really wants just to live happy with all of her people, and I think she can because she is like that. Do you remember the girl from season 1? She was innocent, she was sweet, and okay, she changed with all of those years and all of what she did, but she really wants to do great with this new planet, this new moon, so give her the chance to do that. Bellamy, I was really angry during the episode about his storyline, but not because of the character or the actor, but because of the choice that the writers are making with Bellamy. We really had trouble, I had really trouble during season 5 to reconnect with these characters, because okay, all of them changed with the time jump, but they kept what the main goal of each character is about. Not Bellamy. Bellamy, the main goal, the main thing about his character from season 1 to season 4 was to protect his sister, and we lost that during season 5. And to see him really sticking to that thing with this season, I really don't like that, and I'm really not reconnecting with this character, and it's really bad, I think, for the show, because Bellamy is one of the main characters of this show, is one of the leaders with Clark, and we can't understand him. I mean, I can't understand him, what is he saying, why is he saying all of that. Okay, he can be angry with her, but not this level of anger with his own sister. I can't really see that happening. Okay, she did bad things. Okay, she put you in the arena, but at the end, you did also bad things, so come on. Really, I'm tired of that. Octavia also is sticking with what she was during season 5, but I can really understand that, because she was also like that during season 4, and we saw her going on that path, so we can understand why she is doing what she is doing right now. She wants to die, and she feels dead inside, so we can understand her. I can understand her. One thing is really missing during this episode. We don't see Raven being sad about Shaw's death. Come on! Not even a minute with her talking about him, with her crying for him. Okay, she cried during the last episode, during episode 2, but for what? 3 seconds? Really, I need more than just that. Really. The storylines about this new world, the flashbacks, the things about the children of Gabriel, the descendants of Josephine, the naming day, all of that, it's really interesting and it's really like we can try to figure it out, but we can't, but because we don't have all the keys to understand it. So yes, that's great, that's really great. So it's all for the episode 3 right now, and like I said at the beginning of this video, I'm gonna be late for episode 4 because I'm moving during next week on a new apartment, which is at 400 kilometers from this one. So yes, I'm gonna be late for maybe 1, 2, or 3 days, but I will be back, I promise. Okay, so it's all for me and it's all for the 100 now, so bye for now. Bye.